It has been a long road, but Harry Miller, a former police officer, is celebrating what he's called a massive victory for free speech.
People are offended, whether it's Brexit, Tories, elections, you know, in and out, whatever. People are offended all the time. Simple offence cannot be a measure of for triggering police involvement.
Mr. Miller found himself at the centre of a hate crime investigation after he was challenged over 31 gender-critical tweets between November 2018 and January the following year. In one message he wrote, "I was assigned mammal at birth, but my orientation is fish. Don't misspecies me." In another, he asked, "You know the worst thing about cancer? It's transphobic." He also liked a limerick posted by another account that included the phrase, "Your vagina goes nowhere." Mr. Miller's tweets and other interactions were reported to the police by a transgender woman referred to as Mrs. B. It was then that officers contacted him about his comments and warned he could face prosecution.
The judge has said that, one, none of my tweets were even in the foothills of harassment, and two, that homicide police acted like the Stasi, the Gestapo and the Cheka. Now, that is quite a statement, quite a statement.
But the High Court ruling stated that Humberside Police had disproportionately interfered with Mr. Miller's right for freedom of expression. The Humberside Force has now issued a statement saying its handling of the incident was in good faith, but they will learn from the ruling and move forward. But trans rights campaigners fear the decision, if it's misinterpreted, could encourage people to overstep the mark.
He's basically saying, look, if people are nasty to you on Twitter, just go away. And if you expand that into other areas, if people are nasty to you, just go away, then that actually sort of gives a green light to bullying.
Mr. Miller says his case, though, is a victory for common sense. And the right to speak freely, even if others find the remarks offensive, is a basic hallmark of a functioning democracy. Alex Rossi, Sky News, Central London.